Okay, so even though it's not technically Shabbat anymore, because it is after sundown on Saturday, I am going to include this into my Shabbat segment. Where do I want to start? I want to start with what my room looks like. So this is my room. And you can see I have a bed. The linens provided from the university. I have a huge closet. Then I have a desk, and that is my own bathroom right there. And if you come with me out this way, I am actually in the bomb shelter room. So not only do I have this door over here, but I also have this door over here, which is a lot thicker and a lot stronger, which is what you want in a bomb shelter door, supposedly. So then if you come over here into the kitchen, you can see I have a refrigerator. We've all contributed our own kitchen supplies, and the only thing we have to cook hot food with is a hot plate. So if anybody knows any awesome hot plate recipes, that would be really helpful. Living room, and then over there are some other bedrooms. I have a really cool courtyard. Watch. Ready? It's gonna be really freaked out when they come home. They're like, why is that halfway closed? I don't know. I've made a lot of new friends here. Hi, guys! So I have actually made friends here. Everyone get in.
Oh my gosh,
hi! Alright, so first Friday, everything has shut down, so we took it upon ourselves to go exploring. Somehow we ended up on a roof, so you can see it all behind me, but what's really cool is the other behind me.
The other behind?
Yeah.
You kill me.
So yeah, this is where we live now. I hope I can get all this in. It's really annoying not having a back-facing camera, so like I look like really dorky every time I'm doing this.
You don't have a back-facing camera?
No, I don't. It's just forward-facing. So like if you ever see me like going like this and like trying to hit the button that way, that's why.
It is like the selfie camera.
Yeah, well, so it's perfect for me. But so.
So what I'm saying is.
Yeah, so we're just exploring around. There's a shopping arcade on campus that we are going to try to check out, but everything's closed. So now we're just going to explore and see if we can find anything. Probably not. So my friend Robin, everything's closed on Friday and we were very hungry and we didn't want any of the food that we had back home. So we had these really nice vending machines here and we didn't have anything smaller than the hundreds for all of us. So Robin was the brave soul who put in her 100 and it wouldn't give us change back. So now right now she is stocking up on yogurt and sandwiches and she's being a real champ about it. I want to hear it say.
I hate everything.
she's been great enough to let me videotape this.
I would love your unicorn bag. Thank you. I know, I've got so much yogurt in this one.
And every time it says Toda, we're like, fuck you. So one of the cool things about my university is that if you look behind me, you can see the tower that's on campus. And this is a national park right behind me.
Hi.
Yeah. So we're about to go hiking in this. And by we, I mean everyone around me. I didn't just pick up random people.
Hi.
Disgusting. Ew.
Dirty, nasty people.
You like what question?
It's like, why am I laughing at the children falling down off the mountain?
We're loud.
Stupid, obnoxious children.
Stupid, obnoxious Americans. Cute face.
I know, right?
Stupid, sexy Flanders.
All right, so we're on our way back to the university, and we got done hiking, and if you can see behind me where the tower is, no? Yes? Maybe? Well, there's Ivan. Behind Ivan.
Hello.
There it is. There's the tower. So the guys decided to take a nice little shortcut. So this is the path right here that we're going to go on, and it's going to loop all the way up to the same ending point, but there
They're doing it. They're going to climb up there. Yeah, and you can kind of see a little bit where the tower is behind. So they're doing it right up there. Bye, guys.
Bye.
So if Andrew and Ivan get deported, that's why.
There's no one to take a picture. We could always do a selfie if we needed to.
But yeah. We'll be able to get the sun in there.
That's actually, I like have never watched the sun like actually set.
I haven't either.
It's really pretty.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
All right, well, it's Sunday, the day before classes, and the last few things we're going to get done today is go get our bus passes, which will give us unlimited rides per a year, so that's going to be interesting trying to figure that out because we had to fill out the forms in Hebrew. Luckily, we have Inbar, who lived here until she was 13, and so she knows a little bit of Hebrew and can help us out. So I'm about to walk and meet up with everybody so we can do that. Oh, and afterward, we might go to the beach, which is exciting. But one thing I want to show you guys is, if you can see behind me, our campus is very confusing, especially in the dorm rooms. So I have this little guy right here that first day he was smiling. See, he was smiling because he was mocking me because I was lost. And now he's a landmark of encouragement where he's like, you go, Amanda. You know where you're going. You got this. So I just wanted to point that out and then let you guys know what we're doing. And hopefully you have images after that. All right, bye. All right, so getting the Rob-Cop card for a whole year actually led us to go to 4 different offices, talk to 4 different people, and it was about, I don't know, how long would you guys say it took us to get the Rob-Cop card? Like, hour and a half? 2 hours? 2 hours, something like that. We'll go with 2 hours. So, to treat ourselves for afterward, we are now at the beach. You can kind of see behind me, but I'll get a close-up, don't you worry. Here's the beach!
Yep.
So to give you a little context of Israel's culture, I want to show you guys this sign. I don't know if you can see it. So there's a sign right there that says no, we're calling it smash paddle. It's where they basically paddling, it's like ping pong. And then as you can see, right there, there are 2 gentlemen playing smash paddle, basically right next to the sign. Let's see if they can do it. Yep, yep, yep. Why it's a rule, I don't know, but it's a rule and there's a sign that blatantly says it. And right next to it are 2 older gentlemen, one wearing a Speedo, playing smash paddle. So that's Israel culture in a nutshell. All right, so if I were to make a video without making a special shout out to Hubar, I wouldn't be doing my job fully because this is literally where we've been every single night since we've been here because they have 50 shekel pitchers, which is the best deal you can get. And it's right down the walkway from our dorms. You know what, I'm gonna have an enriching video to add to this experience and you're gonna be left with nothing.
Sorry. Sarah, you're my favorite.
All my friends make fun of me for having a video blog when everything cool happens, so. So then they're gonna be in it, so whatever. They're just gonna be in it again. Elliot showed up.
Hi.
This is Sarah.
So it's about 2 hours later, and this is what Hubar looks like right now.
Like you can do yoga.
No guards at your parliament?
No, you can do yoga on the front lawn or play frisbee. Who cares?
Well, I mean, like, I figured there'd be guards.
There's guards inside. There's guards inside, like, watching, but you can just, like, walk in. You don't have to, like, go through a security check really or anything. You kind of have to, like, take off your...
So, yeah, this is our
lives. You go through a scanner, and that's it.
Okay.